God wants his word understood differently. When you compare the pure truth, which is conveyed to you from above, with those teachings which until now were known as my word, then you must notice the immense error you live in. It is your duty to openly declare your position in regards to it. You cannot agree that one can look upon something in this and that way. Instead, my word will always have the same meaning and will also correspond to the word from above. People merely interpret it differently. My adversary took possession of the human intellect and caused confusion, for intellectually all interpretations were possible. But I had given you a spiritual interpretation and was only able to convey it to a spiritually awakened person, but who is wholeheartedly in tune as to how my word is to be understood and who shall also make an effort in order to combat wrong interpretations. He shall make people aware of them and instruct them in the same meaning as I have done and still continue to do, so that they will live in truth, which alone leads to beatitude. Their attention shall be drawn to the fact that I want everything to be understood differently, that people shall understand my words spiritually and also fulfill them spiritually. They shall let themselves be nourished and refreshed by me myself, and this absolutely necessitates love for me and their neighbor, otherwise they will be unable to experience the grace of my address, otherwise they will not be able to hear my word as a sign of my presence. Hence external signs and traditions are of no use to you in order to be certain of my presence in you. Only love must be in you, for only through love will my being be certain. In that case, however, you will also receive my word and thus be nourished with my bread from heaven, with the water of life, with my flesh and my blood. And if you spend thought on this interpretation, you will not find any contradiction with the word I have spoken when I lived on earth. I handed the bread and the wine to my disciples, but they knew that I wanted it to be understood as my word which they were meant to hand out to their fellow human beings. But my adversary tried to confuse people by sneaking a different interpretation in which they diligently heeded and thus gradually diverted from the actual meaning of my word. And therefore you must attempt to explain all my words in a spiritual way. You do not understand one word as I want it to be understood. Because my adversary has been very successful in confusing people's mind, but my own were taught by me at all times and always knew the truth. And anyone who followed them belonged to the church founded by me. The interpretation of my words has led to the most varied means of sanctification. To the sacraments which are to result in all people's sanctification. But how can this come about if people are lacking love? The human being only lives on earth for the purpose of changing his nature into love. How can a person, through the act of baptism alone, be delivered from the hereditary sin, which requires a life lived in love on earth? How can a human being be released from all kinds of sins through paying external lip service, if the most profound love for God does not wrench this confession from him? And how can someone released from his guilt through such sanctification means entered the kingdom of the beyond who is only judged according to his degree of love? All misguided teachings are disclosed through my word, through the instructions from above. And you can form your own opinion about them. For you must have the certainty that you received the purest truth from one side and that I myself am the source of this truth, that I can also explain to you how I want my word to be understood, but that I will also grasp every opportunity to do so where possible, for my adversary has successfully managed to draw you all under his spell. And you do not defend yourselves through your own will for truth, you accept everything presented to you without hesitation and not even once turn to the one who is the source of all knowledge, not once do you turn to the highest authority with an appeal for truth, which it would certainly not deny, For I only wait for this call so that I can distribute the truth in its purest form and guide people out of this net of errors into truth. For although I do not infringe upon people's free will, they can use it to help them push the adversary away, providing they only desire the pure truth. Amen.